Okay, very good morning, children. Yesterday we started the first chapter, transport in plants. Yesterday we discussed about the means of transport, which are in three types. So today we are going to continue first chapter with a new topic. What is the new topic, Nani? Water potential. Okay, today we are going to discuss detailed information about water potential. What is water potential? Water potential is the concept, fundamental concept to know about the water movement. What is water potential? Water potential is the fundamental concept to know about the water movement. Water potential is the fundamental concept to know more about water movement. Water movement. So with help of water potential, we came to know water movement. So water potential is the concept of fundamental or fundamental concept. Water potential is the fundamental concept to know more about water movement. To know more about water movement. So especially here you can say solute potential and pressure potential. Solute potential and pressure potential. These two are the main components of the water potential. Okay, solute potential and pressure potential. These two are the components of the water potential. So water potential having two components. One is solute potential, another one is pressure potential. And what is the water pollution? Water pollution is the fundamental concept to know more about water movement. So this water potential having two components. One is the solute potential, another one is pressure potential. So generally water molecules have kinetic energy. Water molecules have generally kinetic energy. Okay, already you know about the kinetic energy. In chemistry, in physics, especially in physics, you have learnt about the kinetic energy. So water molecules particularly having kinetic energy. Water molecules particularly having kinetic energy. The greater in the concentration of water in a system, greater its kinetic energy, means its water potential. Suppose greater in the concentration of water in a system, suppose if the system having more and more water concentration, greater in the concentration of water in a system, that having a greater water potential means that having greater kinetic energy. So pure waters have more and more water potential compared to other solutions. Especially pure water having more and more water potential compared to other solutions. Suppose if the water potential of, suppose if the system having more and more water concentration, its kinetic energy also more, its water potential also more. So especially pure water having more and more water potential compared to remaining solutions. And generally you can observe water always moves from one of the high potential to another one to the low potential. So water always moves from high potential to water always moves from high potential to low potential. High potential to low potential. High potential to low potential. Water always moves from one of the high potential to one of the lower potential. And the water potential is expressed with a Greek word. The water potential is expressed with a Greek symbol. Greek symbol psi. Greek symbol psi. The water potential is expressed with a Greek symbol psi. And generally it is expressed in pressure units called pascals. And generally it is expressed in pressure units pascals. Okay. And generally it is expressed in the pressure units pascals. The water potential is denoted with a Greek symbol psi. Generally it is expressed in pressure units pascals. And one more thing here you can remember. At a standard temperature and which there is no without you using any pressure. At a standard temperature and which there is no pressure, we can take water potential of pure water is zero. At standard temperature and which there is no pressure in particular, pure water, water potential we can take zero. At standard temperature and where there is no pressure, we can take pure water, water potential zero. Okay. And one more thing here you can remember. What is solute potential? Solute potential. If any solute, what is solute potential? If any solute is added to the pure water, if any solute is added to the pure water, any solute means any sugar or salt. If any solute is added to the pure water, decreasing the fewer free water molecules. If you add any solute to the pure water, there should be decreasing of the free water molecules, its concentration also decrease and its potential also decrease. Whenever you add solute to the pure water, there should be decreasing of free water molecules, and also there should be decreasing of water concentration, and there should be decreasing of water potential. So especially the lowering of water potential, because of the lowering of water potential by dissolution of solute is called solute potential. By dissolving the solute only, the water potential is reduced. So that type of the potential is called solute potential. Lowering of, what is solute potential? Lowering of water potential by dissolution of solute is called solute potential. Lowering of water potential due to dissolution of solute is called solute potential, which is always negative. Solute potential, which is always negative. At atmospheric pressure, if you take at the atmospheric pressure, water potential is equal to solute potential. At the atmospheric pressure, the water potential is equal to solute potential. Water potential symbol you can see psi double. Solute potential symbol you can see psi s. So at the standard atmospheric, at the atmospheric pressure, water potential is equal to pressure potential, psi double is equal to psi s. So this is about the solute potential. But now what is the pressure potential? Pressure potential means if pressure is greater than atmospheric pressure is applied on the pure water. If the pressure is greater than atmospheric pressure is applied on the pure water, then the water potential is increased. Okay, generally the water enters, generally the water enters into the plants to diffusion. Whenever the water enters into the plant cells, that creates pressure on the cell wall. Then the cell becomes turgid. Then the cell becomes turgid means swollen. Then the cell becomes turgid. Okay. Then the, whenever the water enters into the cells through diffusion, they create pressure on the cell wall. So because of the entering of the water into the cells, they create pressure on the cell wall, as well as the water size will increase. That is the turgid cell. So increment of water potential in turgid cell is called pressure potential. So whenever the water enters into the cells, they can create pressure on the cell wall. As a result, the cell become turgid, cell becomes swollen, the cell size will increase. Swollen cell, that is called turgid cell. So because of the increment of water potential in turgid cell is called pressure potential. Pressure potential is always positive, which is a symbol of psi p. So this is, these are the solute potential and pressure potential. These two are the components which are present in the water potential. So here, solute potential and water potential, they can form the solute potential and pressure potential, they can form the water potential. So there is a relationship between these three potentials. So the relationship we can show in the form of the one equation. So here you can see, water potential is equal to solute potential plus pressure potential. Water potential is equal to solute potential plus pressure potential. Okay, water potential is equal to solute potential plus pressure potential. So this is about the detailed information of water pollution. With the help of water, with the help of water potential, we came to know the movement of water. So water potential having two components. One is solute potential, another one is pressure potential. Water molecules having kinetic energy. If any system of the water concentration is increased means, then their potential also increased, their kinetic energy also increased. So pure water having more and more water potential compared to remaining solutions, and water always moves from high potential to one of the low potential. And one more thing here, element, the water potential is denoted with a Greek symbol psi. Here you can see Greek symbol psi. And a standard temperature and pressure, we can take the water potential of pure water is equal to zero. And but what is solute potential? If any solute is added to the water, pure water, it's the decreasing of free water molecules, the concentration of the water also decreases, water potential also decreases. So because of the decreasing of water potential by dissolving a solute is called solute potential. In this solute potential, especially we have to add solute to the water, so then the water potential will decrease. So that is solute potential, which is always negative. At the atmospheric pressure, water potential is equal to solute potential. And next coming to the pressure potential, water solute potential symbol psi s. Next pressure potential. If a pressure is greater than atmospheric pressure is applied to the pure water, its potential will increase. Generally, plant cells absorb the water through the diffusion. Whenever the water enters into the plant cell, it can create pressure on the cell wall. As a result, the cell become turgid, swollen. So the increment of water potential in the turgid cell is called pressure potential, which is always positive, which is the symbol of psi p. Here you can see. Next, there is a relationship between this solute potential and pressure potential, water potential, that we can express in the form of a equation. You can see here psi double is equal to psi s plus psi p. Okay, water potential is equal to solute potential plus pressure potential. So this is about the detailed information of the water pollution, which is important for short mark purpose, very important. Okay, next, another topic, important topic. Another important topic, man. Important topic. Osmosis. Another important topic. Osmosis. But what is meant by osmosis? What is meant by osmosis? Osmosis means movement of water or diffusion of water through semi-permeable membrane. Osmosis means movement of water. Osmosis means movement of water through semi-permeable membrane. Through semi-permeable membrane. This is called osmosis. Movement of water. Only movement of water. Water only move through the semi-permeable membrane. Or diffusion of water through semi-permeable membrane. So the rate of osmosis is mainly dependent on concentration gradient and pressure gradient. The rate of osmosis mainly depend on concentration gradient and pressure gradient. Concentration gradient and pressure gradient. Concentration gradient and pressure gradient. Okay, these are two factors that can affect the rate of osmosis. And plants generally absorb water through osmosis only, which occur through the concentration gradient without using any metabolic energy, without using any ATP energy. Plants absorb water that is occurred due to concentration gradient. Because of the concentration gradient, because of the change in concentration, plants observe water. While observing water, there is no need of any metabolic energy. There is no need of any ATP energy. Why? Because this is a passive reaction. This is a passive action. This is a passive, osmosis is a passive action. There is no need of any ATP energy. Just concentration gradient is compulsory. Because of the concentration gradient, water enters into the plant. So, generally, water moves from high chemical potential to low chemical potential whenever the equilibrium is carried out. Equilibrium means balancing. Water moves from high concentration to low concentration when the equilibrium is reached. Whenever the equilibrium is reached, two chambers are in the same concentration. For example, suppose water is moved from one chamber to another chamber. The process is continue up to the equilibrium is reached. Whenever the equilibrium balancing is reached, both the chambers are in the same concentration. So water moves up to both chambers got the same concentration. up to that time the water moves from one chamber to another chamber, one place to another place. Whenever the two places reach the same concentration, the water diffusion process is stopped. So whenever they reach the equilibrium balancing, two chambers having same concentration, then they reach the equilibrium, then the water stop to diffuse. And one more thing here you can remember, one of the special, one of the activity which you have learnt in previous classes, potato osmometer experiment already you have learnt in other classes. In potato osmometer, the potato which is kept in the water, the cavity of the potato tube, the potato tube which is kept in the water. So the cavity of the potato tube, you should pour concentrated sugar solution or concentrated salt solution. If you pour on the cavity of the potato tube, so what will happen? The water reached into the potato cavity. In the potato cavity, the solution level will increase. That is the potato osmometer experiment which you have learnt in earlier classes. So take the potato, cut the potato into a cube shape. In that cavity, in that cut shape, you should pour concentrated solution. The potato cube you should keep in beaker water. What will happen after few hours? The beaker water enter into the potato cube. So then the level of the solution in the potato tube will increase. So water which is having low concentration, that can move to high concentration. So when both are having the same concentration. So that is the experiment, potato experiments already you have learnt in the lower classes. Potato osmometer. So water only moves from its high potential to low potential. Both have reached the same potential, then the movement of the water is stopped. So that is the potato experiment already you have learnt in lower classes. Next here you can remember one of the activity here they given. One of the small activity here they given and so here two chambers are there here. So these are the solute molecule. This is the water molecule. So this is the A chamber, this is the B chamber. So here, this is the A chamber, this is the B chamber. Both are separated through permeable membrane. Okay, both are separated with a permeable membrane. Both are separated with permeable membrane. Here A chamber you can see, these are solute molecules, the remaining are the water molecules. Here solute molecules are very less, here water molecules are more. Here you can see solute molecules are more, water molecules are less. So here water molecules are more, means here having high potential. So water which is present in the high potential through this membrane, that can enter into the low potential. So both chambers are reached the equilibrium, then the movement of the water was stopped. So that is called osmosis. So the water which is present in the A chamber, that moved into the B chamber through permeable membrane. Whenever the both chambers are reached equilibrium, then the movement of the water was stopped. The both chambers are in the same concentration. Whenever the both chambers are in the same water potential, the movement of the water was stopped. So this is osmosis experiment. One of the small diagram here they given. So this is the permeable membrane. This is the chamber A, chamber B. Chamber A having less solute molecules, more water molecules. But whereas chamber B having more solute molecules, less water molecules. So here water potential is more, here water potential is less. So water which is having high potential, that moves to the low potential through semi-permeable membrane. Whenever the both chambers are reached the same potential, the movement of the water was stopped. So this is the osmosis, one of the simple experiment. Next, we have one another experiment which explains about the with the help of experiment we came to know more information about the osmosis. With the help of an important diagram, diagrammatic explanation is there. Here you can see, this is one of the small experiment which can show us about the, which can show us osmosis. So in that funnel, you should take concentrated sugar solution. Concentrated sugar solution you should take in funnel. So this sugar solution is separated from the pure water which is present in the beaker. Here the beaker contains pure water. Funnel contains concentrated sugar solution or concentrated salt solution. So funnel which contains concentrated sugar solution, that is separated from the pure water of beaker through a semi-permeable membrane, means egg membrane. So the egg membrane separates what sugar solution which is present in the funnel and pure water which is present in the beaker. So beaker contains pure water, funnel contains sugar solution. Both are separated through a semi-permeable membrane, that is egg membrane. How you can get egg membrane? For that you should collect the raw egg. You should make a small hole at the end of the egg. Then you can remove the yolk. Yolk. You can remove the yolk and albumin. Yolk and albumin means white content, yellow content. You should remove. Then eggshell. Eggshell will remain. That eggshell you should keep in dilute hydrochloric acid. That eggshell you should keep in dilute hydrochloric acid at least 3 to 4 hours. Then you can get a membrane. The membrane is called egg membrane. Okay. So this egg membrane is used as semi-permeable membrane. This egg membrane is used as semi-permeable membrane. So water which is present in the beaker that can enter into the funnel, the water level of the solution level of the funnel will increase through the osmosis. The water which is present in the beaker, the water which is having high potential water that can enter into the sugar solution through the semi-permeable membrane. So whenever the both are reach to the same concentration, the movement of the water was stopped. Whenever the both mediums reach to the equilibrium, the movement of the water was stopped. So suppose if you apply external pressure on the upper part of the funnel, you should apply any external pressure means the movement of the water which is entering into the funnel is stopped. If you apply external pressure means there is no water will diffuse into the funnel. Why? Because here you have to apply at the end of the funnel, you are applying external pressure. No. By applying external pressure at the end of the funnel, there is no water that enter into the funnel. So the pressure which is preventing for the movement of water into the funnel is called osmotic pressure. The pressure which is preventing the movement of water into the funnel, that is called osmotic pressure. So this is the experiment. So remember the experiment. Okay. So this is about the osmosis with a detailed experimental information. Okay. So far we completed water potential and osmosis. In tomorrow class we are going to discuss about the plasmolysis. Okay. Thank you, children.